Hi, my name is May Beaubrun, and I'm a board-certified behavior analyst with Brett and DiNovi Associates. In this video, I'll be talking about stimulus-stimulus pairing. We're going to be going over BAC, B6, and the syntaxis areas, B2, identify and distinguish between stimulus and stimulus class, B12, identify examples of stimulus control, H9, collaborate with others to support and enhance client services. Stimulus-stimulus pairing is a procedure in which two stimuli are presented at the same time, usually repeatedly for a number of trials, which often results in one stimulus acquiring the function of the other stimulus. Research has shown that using stimulus-stimulus pairing and direct reinforcement can teach vocal-verbal behavior to young children with autism. The procedure can be adopted to be used in a variety of different treatment settings. There are three phases of the stimulus-stimulus pairing protocol. Before implementing the procedure, identify several preferred items to use during the session. Ideally, avoid edibles to promote vocal speech. For students who have a difficult time relinquishing items, have multiples of the same item or items that can be controlled remotely. Identify the target sound or target sounds to be introduced during the stimulus-stimulus pairing session. These sounds can be based on sounds recorded during other observation periods. During phase one, which is pre-pairing, conduct a 5-minute session where staff pairs the target sound with the delivery of one reinforcer at a time. The target sound should be said at least 3 times for each delivery. While the sound is being paired, staff should be extending the reinforcer towards the student so that the learner sees that they're about to receive the item. The reinforcer should be in the student's hand by the time the third sound has been emitted. During phase two, which is the pairing, the procedure is the same as phase one, but instead, prior to releasing the reinforcing item into the student's hands, pause for about 3 to 5 seconds to attempt to evoke a discrete sound. Deliver the reinforcer immediately upon a discrete sound being made, which may or may not be a target sound. If no sound is produced, repeat the sound 2 more times and use differential reinforcement, delivering the item for a shorter duration of time. During post-pairing, which is phase three, the procedure is exactly the same as phase two, but instead, reinforcements delivered contingent upon the production of a discrete speech sound. Data collection should include the number of times the reinforcer was delivered with the target sound, the number of times another speech sound was emitted, what reinforcers were used, and any challenging behaviors that were observed. The stimulus-stimulus pairing session should be done several times throughout the day. The recommendation is to collaborate with the speech therapist when delivering this treatment to maximize the coordination of care as well as outcomes. Because of the brevity of the procedure, it can be conducted during a speech session and allow time to target other speech and language goals as well. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and disseminate the science. Share this video. Mm-hmm.